And welcome to the Real Wrestling League Discotheca. I am your host, Will Bobbians, also known as Hey Hey Hey, it's Bobbin at the Big Stick Guy.
And I am the co-host, Rob Williams, the fine bureaucrat who knows pretty much everything.
See, I told you it wouldn't sound uncanny at all.
Anyways, we have an exciting pay-per-view coming up for you tonight. We have so many new matches, and God knows what how we learn to build change after tonight.
Well, it changes after every night, at least a little bit.
But let us get into our first match of the evening. I'm of course talking about Jay Marvel taking on Pooper Peter.
Yes, indeed.
These two have had a fight for a while now. Yes. Here we go. Wait a minute.
Here he comes, Jay Marvel, the black sheep of creativity that nobody really likes.
Tell me about it.
Don't steal my catchphrase.
Here comes Papa Peter. His fierce look tells everything you need to know. And from a search the petty text, we found out what is the problem between these two guys.
Oh, now you will finally see, Papa Peter. Just how much I despise your guts, and you will tell me the secrets of creativity. I have heard rumors.
I am not telling you anything. You know, matter if you beat me, confidential permission is still confidential permission.
Why is Ross Owens the referee?
The heck if I know. And I know that's not Ross Owens, that's the Everberg. Saying that just makes me vomit.
Why is he the special referee for this contest?
I don't know, maybe Lisa Marie and Sly didn't want to deal with J-Mar. Understandable.
Oh!
These two, we have heard a lot about creativity's confidential information thingy.
What does it mean?
Well, it means that they have secrets. There are a lot of things that should not be known to the public. And it seems to me that there was some suspicion that creativity is not what it seems. There is a leadership group that tries to take control of things.
Is that might explain a lot of things, actually. All about that creativity and power frequency. What with a rotten guy eating each other.
Yes, but that's all in the past now. You know, guy was able to get rid of rot in a matter of minutes.
Yeah, Pooper Peter strikes to the top rope, but he misses.
Yes, indeed. He set that microphone on fire. Oh my goodness, they knocked each other out.
Pooper Peter continued to his brutality streak.
I have high hopes for this. Or at the very least, Pooper Peter. Jay Marvel, I'm not so sure about. Ross Owens says that was somehow, that was not a road break.
I'm starting to think Ross Owens might be biased.
Yes, they are going into the outside, goddammit. Dog for them, what the heck is he doing here? This match is not yet.
Oh, he attacks Pooper Peter.
There seems to be something going on.
Oh,
the dog for the fell into that chair, that must have hurt his head. Probably. The battle outside the ring continues. Oh my god. Ross Owens knocked himself out. And now, Jay Marvel is... it's going on. He might get counted out. No, he didn't. It was almost counted. Pinfall, but it doesn't count. Jay Marvel is stupid. Yes, if he wouldn't make any other wrestlers were stupid. I've seen the signs. Bubba Beater with a stunner. Oh my god, you can stop for them. Oh, slamming Purple Peter. I know Dark Forbidden has beef with every person on his timeline because he murdered them in cold blood. But wasn't Dark Forbidden? What if Baron of Creek wants to go after creativity on this? I doubt it. Jay Marvel tries to get him. Oh, he flies to the ringside again. Literally didn't see that coming. Dark Forbidden with the money. The brutalities of the capitalist society symbolized through that man. I don't think it's that deep, bro. Jay Marvel is looking for the post for himself. Oh, Purple Peter flies out of the ring again. Is the ring some sort of a magnet that keeps the wrestlers away? We have done this shit for over a year, of course. Purple Peter trying to make things something neat, but Jay Marvel, why is Dark Forbidden helping Jay Marvel? Ooh, Jay Marvel has enough of Ross Owens' shit. He slams into the wall and they are back in the ring for once. Oh, that's Purple Peter trying to make Jay Marvel submit with the face. Purple Peter with a missed kick. Oh, pinfall. 1, 2, 3. Oh, Purple Peter wins. Jay Marvel has to officially give his mouth shut. Dark Forbidden. Well, we will probably find out later.
Purple Peter takes the victory back.
Yes. God knows what will happen to Jay Marvel afterwards.
What's our next match?
I believe it is going to be Mr. Man Productions versus Kill the Hogover.
Interesting. We will see Mr. Man Productions get revenge on behalf of his close friend Chibori Oper. This feud never ends.
Nope, it doesn't. Lisa Marie and Slugsman.
Yes, indeed.
Here she comes. Kill the Hogover. The nemesis of Chibori Oper, father of light, mother of light, 3 RW superstars.
Mr. Man Productions, the man who retired Big Papa's brother, that Muslim guy.
Yes, he was Derek Papa, but he was also known as Asano Mine. Meow! Your days have come to pass because Chibori Oper, why the hell does he still have friends? If I beat you, I will take Chivery back to myself, and your stupid bodyguard then will not help you!
Wow, Mr. Man Productions couldn't get any of his wit back.
Mr. Man Productions had been established. Oh, he puked! The puke on her face!
He's a
I see it in her face, did it smell off?
It's a puke again.
The puke is the best. Yes, it was thanks to Mr. Man Productions that he was able to save Maria Cervantes. Could Mr. Man Productions be the guy who finally releases Tiberi Arbor from the clutches of his evil mother? Oh my god.
They go to the ringside again. Who would have guessed?
It's thanks to Mr. Man Productions that he has been able to keep... He's important. A member of Creativity. He's also active.
Oh, Hilda Hakaber got his bones crushed.
I don't think that's really it. Mr. Man Productions ran away and took a bell with him.
What happened to the bell?
I don't know. They never use items in wrestling matches anymore.
You would think they would hate each other enough to actually use them.
This money and slot goes away in Hilda Hakaber's iconic tennis racket, which she got from her ex-boyfriend, I think, Johnny DeLong. I wonder what that clown is doing nowadays. Oh, there she goes again. Now there she goes again, Shishu.
Well, I love Cinderella song.
Yes, because you keep playing it to me. Your stupid playlist, all the rope time. Oh my god! Hilda Hakaber slammed Mr. Man Productions through that chair thingy. Yes, you, as I was saying, you keep playing that stupid song on your road. Why am I still traveling with you?
Because Thomas Sharp is a bore.
I guess. Oh my god damn it. Anyways. Mr. Man Productions keeps slamming Hilda Hakaber on top of those chairs over and over and over again. It's kind of mean. Mr. Man Productions is hyping himself up.
Knocking each other out and see.
Yes. There's a bit of cum on the stage.
You? Why the heck would you pay attention to that?
Not my fault, there was a white splooge. What do you think it's gonna be?
Maybe it's me from Hilda Hakaber's titties.
You! God damn it! I'm gonna puke!
I'm sorry.
Mr. Man Productions tormenting Hilda Hakaber with those fists. I want to do the same thing now, so that I don't puke.
Forget all that shit, baby. Oh my goodness, Mr. Man Productions with an amazing 2-3. Oh my god!
Mr. Man Productions scores a victory over Hilda Hakaber. Of course, he will probably be a next week.
Yes.
Mr. Man Productions is not taking the adrenaline too well. But at least Hilda Hakaber got total lesson. Of course, no win, sir. She will show up next week again with no chances.
Well, I mean, unless we really want to go backstage and see what was the counterpoint of that.
We probably should. You may have defeated me, Mr. Man Productions, but I will keep coming back until the end of time. Why don't you just give up, Mom? You have been chasing after me for like several hundred years already. I'm getting tired of it. I have moved on. I have seen all my friends fall down, yet you keep still showing up. Do you really want to go around? Why are you constantly chasing after your children and trying to raise them to be better people? So that they don't become as bitter as I have become. I want just one positive male person in my life. Everyone keeps disobeying me. Old PH was the only man I loved for several years and he got killed. Why could things not go my way for once? I'm feeling bad for you at least once, Mom. But I'm sure you will find some old hack to stick yourself into. Yeah, whatever.
I guess this is it for me. I'd much rather go hang around with a bunch of geriatrics than any of you. Life, live your life as you want it, Chibbery. My work is done here.
Well, that was surprisingly easy.
Well, looks like Gilda Hakaber has retired.
Yeah, I kinda feel bad for her.
Well, whatever. She had a good run, but ultimately, it was ultimately left down to only one man who could beat. She really didn't serve any purpose here anymore.
You may be right. So, what's the deal?
Next up, we will have our hardcore triple threat match.
What is it going to be?
Well, nobody knows. It's a basic hardcore match from what I hear. No extra gimmicks or anything.
Wait, there is... what?
No, there actually is an extra gimmick here. It's going to be... it's going to have a barbed wire. We haven't had barbed wire matches in forever.
Whoa, that's going to be interesting.
Indeed. Smogman was challenged by Gunhall and Tomber and Omni at the same time. It is not only a face-off between Smogman and his two rivals, but also a face-off between Renegades, the closest thing to successor to Hyphis, and CEV, who are much more kept trying in terms of title shots. You will later see another match of this kind.
Oh, here we go. But there are no weapons in the ring.
Here he comes, Omni, the first member of the Renegades. Accompanied by Mulito, we'll have a match tonight later. Gunhagen, the last Tomber in CEB. Because this Tomber seems to have disappeared entirely. And here he comes, Smogman and Yubi became friends after Yubi got screwed over by Garnet Mystic or something like that. It's a rough relationship, to say the least. But the prince of him.
Why isn't Smogman getting into the ring?
Well, this is going to be a chaotic match. There are three managers present in here.
It begins.
Lisa Marienz wants to keep up the order of this chaotic match.
Smogman slamming Omni down to the mat to get his win again. He can't reach Smogman.
Is this a... well, from what I have heard, this has elimination. So basically, opponents have to be eliminated. So, this is not a triple threat match.
Well, good, because triple threat matches, they fall forever in these matches, and so it's really short.
There's a bomb! And the managers are brawling. I hope none of them get injured, that would be really embarrassing.
I know how you feel, buddy.
Lisa Marienza is carrying a big piece of glass. Oh my god, she's hurting herself on the barbed wire. Where is Smogman going?
They are too busy fighting on the ringside. I think Omnian... there it is. Omni is trying to eliminate Gunhall and it fails.
Oh, here comes Mulito with a hand.
Oh, Mulito slammed Gunhall in the face with a hammer of his. Gunhall and desperately wanted to do a CEV leader and it proved that he wasn't good at it. So Hank Threshold is now the leader of CEV, or at least the CEV section of RWA.
Well, I mean, CEV technically... CEV, the faction, is the organization of doing things. When we refer to CEV, we refer to...
Oh, fuck off, Omni. I will so end your career here.
Whoa, Lisa Marienzla isn't having any of them. Omni statue, yes, as I was saying. When we talk about CEV, we usually talk about CEV, the faction. unless it's CEV, the organization, which is led by Boris Cox, and it's related to executions.
Oh no, not this shit again.
What is up with that? It seems that my camera is malfunctioning. It's been going on like this forever. I have to next week have somebody to fix this.
Smoke man brutally crosses on his head on the pavement.
But here comes Gun. I guarantee this is going to be a chaotic match full of surprises and twists. What the hell is this? A moving firm? Why can't Chuck do? Guys, get into the fight.
Omni smashing Smoke Man's head. Gunhalen with a hit might be it.
But it failed. Who will be the new hardcore champion? Smoke Man kicking Omni to the face. Gunhalen carries two tables at once. A table top or might be four.
Smoke Man point my Omni submit. Oh my goodness, Goofy slammed to the wall.
Oh, Mulito's climbing on top of the table structure. Now they are Smoke Man and Gunhalen are teaming up to kick Omni's ass, but Omni now tries to go for a UPR strikes.
Oh, Omni's not bad. It's a chaotic thing.
Indeed. Mulito is now fighting Smoke. He needs to reserve energy for his own match. Against Vex. Okay, DIY and Sosa will take turn to Vex and Mulito, which might lead to an execution. That could be extreme.
Smoke Man, leave me alone. Okay, I'm done with you too.
No! You can't be serious! What the hell? Yuppie keeps getting the worst luck. I was starting to grow on these two.
Yuppie will never find a partner, it seems.
Well, they are back in the ring. I'm feeling that Yuppie has been rejected from now 40 people. This includes God on the Mystic, Casper Passable, Cassie, and now Smoke Man.
And if you think he led Smoke Man to greatness, only went through a stretcher. Mulito is now involved, and Elisa Marienzola slammed Gunhall into the back of her head.
Oh my god, that sound of the bodies hitting the floor. Smoke Man can't take it, even the giant monster made of pollution has his limits. Gunhalen has a brass knuckle.
Omni is trying to make Smoke Man submit.
Mulito with a really bad punch.
Omni has been eliminated, it's down to Smoke Man.
Oh my god, stop with this. Why is Gunhalen beating up Smoke Man? Smoke Man's now at the bank threshold.
He's taking his aggression out. Smoke Man's pissed.
This Marine Slam has run to the back wall. Everyone's fighting. Gunhalen and Omni are working together. I never thought I'd see the day.
Ooh. You can't wrestle as a flaming basketball or something like that.
It's a blank. One of those K-Fabian tweets. No. Alright, Smoke Man and Gunhalen return to the ring. There is blood everywhere. Slamming through that barbed wire and they are going back. I want to get back to the outside. Thankfully this is on.
Ooh. Smoke Man goes for the pin, but I don't know how that was possible.
Well, Smoke Man's made of liquid, so natural slippery might be possible. Bank Threshold carries a trash.
Ooh! Striking stopping Mulito from attacking Smoke Man from a moving trash. That was amazing.
Oh no.
Bank Threshold is now trying to pretend he is part of this match. Molito still here despite the fact his friend got eliminated. Here he comes. Smoke man slamming. Oh no, it happened again.
Gunnhallen should already strike the opportunity while the iron is hot. He should jump on top of Smoke Man and pin him right there and there.
Looks like Bank Threshold is doing more fighting. And the Bank Threshold prevents Smoke Man from attacking Gunnhallen.
Alright, this might be it.
Well, it's not really. Smoke Man continues to slam. Gunnhallen continues to slam. He's become much more competent from his old days.
Almost had it.
Smoke Man's dizzy. That's not a good sign. Bank Threshold with a knife!
Well, Bank Threshold really wants Smoke Man to lose. Why is he pinning him? She's not part of the match.
Well, here comes Gunnhallen. Bank Threshold is doing all the work for Gunnhallen.
Well, they are communists or something, so they believe that all the work must be served.
Watch. This match is... people are getting tired of this match. Smoke Man is just... Why the hell is Gunnhallen not doing anything? I'm getting mad. Let's do this, I'm complete idiot. And Molito is not getting involved, despite the fact his involvement in this match is 100,000% irrelevant.
Oh, Gunnhallen beating Smoke Man with a... Here we go! This might be it. 1, 2...
No! Somehow, Lisa Marienzla was too slow.
I don't blame him.
Gunnhallen. Would Gunnhallen really be able to defeat Smoke Man?
Well, I don't know, but could they really be able to defeat the audience's portal?
Smoke Man trying to make Gunnhallen submit. What is it with Discotheca having the most cursed hardcore matches?
Well, it's million times better than the last year's match, my God. Both of those people went out of the company.
Yeah, so no wonder. Now Bank Threshold is getting involved once again. Gunnhallen slams Smoke Man down.
It seems Gunnhallen that... Oh my God!
Well, if that doesn't finish Gunnhallen, then I don't know what will.
Well, Gunnhallen still up. Gunnhallen slams Smoke Man down. The blood is hit striking. The barbed wire is cutting them open like paper.
The audience is released. Board. And Smoke Man is just rocking like... Oh my goodness, I don't know what to do. Come on now. Bank Threshold drops Smoke Man. Technical difficulty.
Alright. Come on.
Smoke Man. Gunnhallen with a pretty big punch. 1, 2, 3. Gunnhallen wins the RKPL Hardcore Championship. Finally. What the hell is Bank Threshold doing?
She's celebrating. CDV has unlocked new championship finally.
Yes. Smoke Man seems to have gone through a change.
I don't like it in the slightest.
Well, Gunnhallen has the victory on CEV now owns 2 titles out of 4.
Technically, I know Lambert,
if only Lambert Tomber was still part of CEV.
Tell me about it.
And next up we have some tag team action.
first of the many matches tonight, featuring it, tag team action that is. Of course, I'm talking about... you know... What? You know... What? It's... Alright. It's off. I'm of course kidding. It's Milo Fortune. Take it. Milo Fortune and Silas Stretcher are working a strange alliance to take on... the Dark Fortune and Big... the Baron of Krieg. Whoa. I'm scared. I'm spooked. Well, don't be. Yes, Baron of Krieg for once performs in the middle of the show, which is kind of surprising.
Here we go.
Here they come, the two demons, Dark Fallen and the Baron of Krieg, the immortal spirit of war. They seem to have some plans prepared for Fallen.
Here they come.
Silent Ranger who lost his iconic vest because he had to obey Mulito's law, so we didn't get a vest in. Fallen. I was expecting, why didn't he get into the ring? Right, I have done it. Fortan, anything to stop the evil plans of Dark Fortan and Baron of Krieg, whatever they are planning.
You cannot stop the inevitable.
Once I have Fortan on my side, nothing can stop us. Well, and Dark Fortan should realize he's talking about himself from an alternate time.
Exactly. These two look nothing alike now that Dark Fortune is such a... because of their difference in bodies. And the fact that Dark Fortune is bald.
Oh no, Baron of Krieg has been tagged against Fortune.
Why doesn't Baron of Krieg use any of his magic shit?
Well, to be honest, I have no clue. Well, I mean, maybe he's not allowed to.
Oh,
they are going outside the ring.
Why was there technical difficulties in the middle of Silent Stranger's brawl?
Silent Fortune attacks Dark Fortune. They are all crawling in the ringside. That's not a good sign.
Silent Stranger gets involved in both his partners. Baron of Krieg shows his superior intelligence and power to the Dark. To be poor old Fortune. Who can help you? Nobody can.
Hello.
Hello there.
Pardon, I missed. Surprised to see you. It's been a while.
Yes, I have been
keeping a low profile because I was one issue. It's starting to play out all the same. Look at the Baron of Krieg. He continues to make me sad. Why is that? I don't know. Fortune. I have seen the end of times coming here, Fortune, and we all will suffer from pain that is about to occur to us. You can tell it from my worst plans, Kevin. Well, what can be done to prevent this apocalypse? Only Jason can free us from this pain. What do you think Jason can do? I remember you brought up Jason like a few weeks ago. Well, even if Jason can save us, we still have to deal with death, because for he is the representation of death.
Yes, I recall you say something like that.
Vex! What the hell is it? Oh, come on.
Maybe he is,
Dark Water with a pinfall attempt. 2, 3,
you should probably stop at Saturday. This is not a Final Fantasy game or whatever it is.
You laugh at me. Even if you don't like to laugh at me for... I know there is something that you must know.
Okay.
What a weird guy that guard on the Mystic is.
Well, I don't like it. Silas Rachel just lost to Darkforden. What the hell is about to happen to both of these guys? Let's find out.
Forden, no matter what entity you align yourself with, no matter how many times you convince other people that you have changed, nothing changes the fact that we are the same person, and all roads lead to me.
I am not scared of you. You are just an angry bully who got so mad in his own timeline that he decided to rise up into Rakesh, and now you are so insecure you want to make every other timeline that is more successful with less of an asshole than you to their knees.
Baron of Krieg, why don't you deal with him?
I'm trying to...
Baron, what the hell just happened?
What is going on here?
Forden, you seem to have something inside of you.
I do?
Yes, come with me and we'll talk it out.
Baron! Master! Speak to me! Master!
What the hell was that? That boy has something in him. And I don't like it. Darkfire, you're made of the same blood as him. Why don't you have that power?
I don't know.
This requires better story. Let's leave.
What about me?
Oh, well, I don't like it. For the first time ever, I saw Baron of Krieg actually writhe in pain as he tried to do something to Forden. It's as if, like, there's something inside of him that is... nothing like we've ever seen.
Tell me about it, but I don't really like this. What about Guy and Maria Cervantes?
Yes, that match is next. Let us go to Guy and Maria Cervantes, who... from what I understand, they are... Guy is about to save Maria Cervantes from his weird father, and... a conversion therapist he brought up with him, Dr. Provoca. They kidnapped Mario Cervantes last week and now Guy is set to save him. Let's see if he succeeds.
Let me out! Let me out! Guy, save me! Guy! Father, you...
are you taking your time with it, Dr. Provoca?
Yes, you did this strange testosterone, the second phase of returning your comeback to normal can begin.
Let me out!
Can you keep it up? I'm starting to get really tired of that infernal noise.
Just a small minute. It's almost done. What was that?
Guy! It's you! You saved my life! I never thought I would be saved from the clutches. I don't even want to imagine what kind of horrible things they would have done to me.
Well, well. Now you are finally free, Mario Cervantes. Thanks to Chad Ingalls' Hungarian smoke bombs, I was able to knock those two out and track down with that car.
Thank you, Guy. Let's go. This place brings me back.
Not so fast. Did you really think that your feeble little smoke bomb was going to distract me? Oh.
I know this place's foundation likes the bottoms of my empty pockets. You just interrupted science, and when you interrupt science, you interrupt progress, you degenerate! Don't you dare, or both of you will be blown up!
Careful, guy. He might be an asshole, but he's still my father.
Look at that. You still have a bit of man's blood in you.
The chains are terrible things! Guy, smoke them!
I'm doing my best. Oh no, it's broke. Alright, let's take this man and woman to man and man.
I'd like to see you try. I have learned my bodyguard myself.
You have studied in the Russian army to become the ultimate defense machine. Both of you are screwed.
Oh, here it goes. That is a weird-ass looking house. Well, Dr. Provoker seems to be... What is with that counting? I believe that might be an invisible force. That looks rot fast. Like an arena, Dr. Provoker. I think we are projecting the audience into the walls of Dr. Provoker's office. Well, that takes out from the immersion. That is fast counting. Indeed. Oh my goodness, we begin with Guy attacking Dr. Provoker. Oh no! Guy, where are you going? Your girlfriend's getting crossed. We aren't seeing anything. Oh no. Mario Cervantes seems to be injured. But here comes Guy attacking Dr. Provoker. Save her, Guy. You can do it.
8, 9, 10.
Mario Cervantes is out. Now Guy is shocked. Here goes Esteban Cervantes. We can't see any of the action. Come on, Dr. Provoker attacks. But here comes Esteban Cervantes with our kendo stick. These are already they are establishing themselves to be extremely dangerous.
Yeah, and if to think father injured her own his own child. Not even Gilda Hakoba was that evil.
Yes, I already miss her.
Don't. Well, she was pretty unimportant. Anyways, the audience enjoys the brutalities of man. As we see, Dr. Provoker's. The battle takes place in Dr. Provoker's office. Guy now trying to make Esteban Cervantes submit.
Dr. Provoker is in the sidelines. Oh no!
1, 2, 3.
Oh no, this to one.
You cannot stop me. I will, even if you take, you will remove my soul.
This does not look good. I don't even care to look. Maria is still trying to protest, but Esteban is aware that he has won.
Alright, Dr. Provoker. Take Maria to the backstage, so we can resume our project. You better get out of here, Guy, if you know what's good for you. You dare to turn my son into a degenerate? No way, Jose. Your daughter is not a degenerate! She wants to be free to express and show that she has her own freedom to be whoever she wants to be. You are just trying to be a counter-freak to her. Why do you want to strip her out of her freedom? It's simple. I am a famous flamenco performer, and I do not want my son to be a friculo. He will be a future star singing with his father on stage. He already abandoned me, and I do not want another embarrassment from him. Well, he is not your son, and he is will soon not be your daughter, Aether, if you keep going this bloody mess up.
Just try and stop me. Esteban is going to get back to normal soon enough once Dr. Provoca is finished with him. Now get out before I call the police.
Well, you think you should call the police? What about your friend's stupid laboratory? Conversion therapy is illegal in this part of the country.
Actually, I have found a loophole which allows me to continue my experiments without any short of backlash.
You will hear about this.
Mario, I'm sorry. I will save you from there as soon as I can, even if I have to sacrifice myself for it.
This entire stupid conversion building will burn!
Whoa. This looks extremely serious. Poor Mario Cervantes. Poor guy. I hope they are able to bust those assholes.
Me too.
So, but we have no option but to move on to our next match of the evening. Which is actually one of the few matches with no field behind it. It's going to be Clarence Mason taking on Dr. Cox.
Yes. What were the rules? Of a average competitive match?
Well, for one, there are simply no items allowed on this ring. And that's it.
Well, that's kind of... Well, I mean, the competitive championship seems to have lost its ways.
Yes, because it can be defended in any kind of match. It possibly needs to be renamed to something else. Here we go.
Here he comes, Dr. Coles, a new member of the Resistance, accompanied by Slick, surprisingly.
Oh no, it's... Yes, Clarence Mason. We haven't seen him or inferred him for a while. I think they are still going after CEV.
Indeed.
It seems that they are trustworthy of Lambert Pompo. Yes. The battle begins by them going outside, which is very uncompetitive, as they are brawling on the rings. Then here comes Axe, who I believe is possibly betting for Clarence to win this match.
Definitely, I won't deny that.
Every manager is taking on each other. It's a big battle.
It is. Perfect.
How are things here? It's been a while. Hello, Inferno. I'm so happy to see you finally back into your senses.
Yes. I haven't been performing on matches because after I got the brainwashed, I had a terrible headache. Any idea what happened while I was born?
Well, I mean, Merc was the world champion for a while.
Merc, my friend. Who was able to beat the championship?
It was Baron of Greek.
Dr. Count. You seem to be too obsessed with yourself.
Oh no, not another few. Well, extraordinary, some money ends not into the ring.
Well, I don't also want to put the card in my system for a while.
Well, what is your plan regarding CEV?
I really don't want to grow. maybe it's the most lawless chicken ever. Because of Dave Labor's part of the past or September where I got nothing to do with it. It was the stupid smog monster. Look at that. Yes. Now that stupid smog monster lost his right when I just couldn't harm the club ends as he's now to make that question. What? The truth is we really cannot tell anything. And because those backstage cameras were destroyed, it was technically a relief in the sense that we no longer need to be shown what we are doing and no longer the backstage. Still, we are close to completing our plan. It's clear that CEV is not in the same power it used to be, especially since that Baron of Creek died. Apparently, the perpetrator. Yes, Baron of Greek seems to be stay away from the mine event for now, but he seems to have other plans. When do you think this expulsion of the CEV will happen? I cannot tell CEV very well. But we are doing fast moves. Especially since Harvard Stoughton. That's great. What is Clarence doing? The battle continues. Dr. Cox is pretty much drunk. Or he's dizzy or something. Almost got another out.
Yes.
And what's next after seeing me? Well, I will see it be. It is possible that they aren't going to get down, because they seem to know about Boris Coxcart's dark secret, but I still think we have to tell them what kind of person he really is. Yes, understood. Where do you think he's going? I don't know. It seems that Lambert and Thunder's betrayal of him was enough, and now he's just thumped.
Oh, jumping off the rope. 2, 3, Clarence does it again.
Very nice. I'm pretty tired of constantly working out. And
Clarence Mason and Dr. Cox have fallen out.
Well, I don't like the sound of that.
Yes.
Our second to last match is going to be Deugwai taking on Mulito and Vex. Any thoughts on that, Inferno?
Well, CEB already has one championship. I really hope they do not win more. Who knows what will happen?
Indeed.
Yes. Let's go.
Here we go with the tag team championships. Oh, they are downright accompanied by 2 managers. They won the championship at Police Headquarters. Here they are. The Rhinox. What a threat of the boss. They have changed their start to be more cool.
Ooh.
Yes, finally! The Hive Hiss will be executed as soon as we beat you! You have no chance of winning these map battles!
Shut up. I've got Omni by my side, and Molito, we get our feet to death.
Well, that was surprisingly not to hope for the quest. So, what kind of horrible things did you do when you were in CEB, for now? I actually do not remember. I know I had some involvement with them for a few days. And I... I happened to burn some books that were talking about the proper requirements. That's right. And also I killed all of it. Yes, that was kind of corrupt. What do you think about that? Do you regret it? Well, between you and me, I actually don't, because old PH is an annoying asshole who has to keep bothering at me and my other friends. Mulito's in the ring, taking on Soulset. Yet he gets stuck on the ring, and Soulset rightfully drags him out.
Fire the booger! Well, that's harsh.
Why do they hate the Booker so dread? What did Drake mean?
Don't break a vape.
Oh no, they are entering inside the empty void where nothing counts. Stop it.
Well, there goes Soulset. Not again.
So infer.
Did you actually learn to think like a CEB member?
Kind of, I guess, but honestly, most of my memories, I see the system between this. I can remember anything, and I forgot even more things during after my headache. Understand? Oh no, they can't continue rolling. Please, Mulito, I've exiled some of the work it can do against Soulset. Soulset with a slam. And now he accidentally attacks. Oh, they are going back in the ring.
Ooh.
Soulset, such a toll. Silence, traitor! Of course, it's very boss. Yes, he already lost to Dark, but surprisingly, he didn't stop. Something weird had happened between Fortan and Dark. I mean, the Baron of Creature, for some reason, Baron of Creature did not use his weird dark magic on Fortan.
That's strange.
Vex and Soulset are now gone. So that's bleeding. Well, no, not this again. Prototype is at Killisammer Jensla. Has she got all saying?
Prototype really hasn't been doing anything, has she?
Wrongly, I will be bleeding. Open up, prototype for number. I'm pretty sure that was late. That was it. RWL drop it or lose it.
Is it going to happen again this year?
No, it's going to be another event. We haven't come up with a name for it yet.
I see. Well, drop it or lose is the name, but it didn't really make sense anyways.
Oh my god. Vex slamming Soulset's head to the pavement. His head must be bruised up, but they are still in the ringside. Where nothing counts. Molito even left her. Why doesn't the others leave?
They are short waves to the time. It's really annoying. Reminds me of the match between me and Baron Space for the first time.
Yeah.
Lisa Morienzo had some on around the ring.
Well, of course he does, because he's caught, because she doesn't know what to do. So sad, finally we can see it. No.
Mulito attacks so sad. And he's going to wake us up also, but it doesn't help because nothing at the ringside counts.
Which bullshit. So sad, getting pretty dizzy.
And so is Mulito.
Come on, get back into the ring already. Going being on the ringside is even more annoying than being outside the ring, because at least there is a crown out, they will actually leave.
I think Mulito might be doing that just to crawl.
So sad doesn't get it because he's always angry. But they have stayed in the ring for a pretty long time.
Take it, Vex.
Yes, this time they are sure to wipe him out properly.
Oh, Omen is attacking. Or Silent Strangers attacking Prototype. It makes sense, they have had a long deal.
Indeed. Again, once again, back to Mulito. Making sure that these two conserve energy exactly the same. Especially since Sosa has been there for a very long time.
I think Inferno went somewhere.
Yes. He probably got bored. Heartless.
Indeed.
Vex. Strike him back. Hey, Jules, all sad out of the stage. Well, this will get even more chaotic now.
The fans are chanting. Vex is not interested.
Give it time. So sad will lay on the ground. Well, there he goes. The temporal leader of CEB faction, Frank Threshold, is watching this thing with great interest. Silent Fletcher is attacking so sad.
It's reference to Silent Fletcher may still have a silent alliance with Omni.
That's absurd. Well, I mean, he probably hates CEB more because they have tried to execute him on several occasions.
Yeah, that. It's like Kiki having to pick between lesser of the two evils.
Sean said he's just roaming around like a zombie of some kind.
And of course this is still in chaos, Delphi is getting involved.
Vex will reset the clock. And set the clock.
There's not very much fighting happening as much as these two are taking on each other in a weird way.
Silent Treacher slamming him down to the pavement. Here comes Still. Vex has a support, or no, he doesn't. So sad is confused, but could he get back into the ring? No, Silent Stranger gets involved, and right to Lisa Marie Insula kicks him. Oh, here we go. Back to normal.
Still, why has a knife?
She's more brutal than ever. What the hell is so sad?
He wanted to get out of the ring, I guess.
Or, there's been a terrible mistake, I agree. Vex.
Well, at least they seem to be getting somewhere, or like in that last match.
Man. A lot of bad players. We have seen you believe Smoke Man now, and then Dr. Boxes leaves Sleep. Really hope that doesn't. I looked at the RWL Discotheca last year, and Omni and Vex are the only tag team that has consistently kept up for the entire year.
That must have been, that's got to be a record or something.
Well, Omni and Vex have been around since early 2014, so technically they are the
longest throw-bomb intact in RWA history. Slot moderators are even longer than that, but they were briefly broken up when Inferno was brainwashed.
Oh!
Oh my god! Vex and Omolito win!
CZB, you people deserve your stupid loss!
I do not have it with Omni can hear you. On where I knew Sinus Rachel wanted to see CEV take a dick in his ass.
That's a very mean language from you, Rob.
Seems like we are might see a change in the future of this company.
I wouldn't be surprised.
And now it's time for our main event, and arguably the match that has been built up to the least. It's Lambert Humber taking on Big Papa, who won a battle royal to get the chance to win the championship to its knees. Lambert Humber won the championship from Baron of Krieg, who was an extremely strong entity. But can Lambert Humber defeat Big Papa? Here we go.
He is the Big Papa.
I bet he's excited to hear about Mario Cervantes.
Fiend, it's Lambert Humber, the babyface champion, the former evil CEV member, the current beloved babyface champion.
Yes.
And welcome, Lambert Humber, the world champion of RWA.
Then Big Papa represent man who the sons Lambert. I don't dare that to beat that tall monkey high. I am going to be your death. Whoa, no Lambert, behold. Well, Big Papa should realize that although Lambert Humber is a tall, monstrous entity, I mean, babyface, he's still a tall monstrous entity who could easily give Big Papa nightmares for the next 5 years.
Yes, we all saw what he did to Baron of Krieg when he lost. He summoned that horrific creature made out of all those dead people that Baron of Krieg took out.
Yes, I wonder what happened. Well, where Big Papa is kicking by Lambert Humber's ass, possibly.
No, Lambert Humber fights back. One, two, almost.
Well, Big, compared to Baron of Krieg, who was pretty tall. But, and dangerous, Big Papa is much fatter, and therefore Lambert Humber, who has a very, you know, he's very skinny. He may not be able to strike offense to Big Papa that well.
Well, I don't want to see a world where Big Papa is world champion. At least Merc had a heroic side, and that plot about him knowing about the evilness of CEV whole time was kind of clever. Big Papa has no reason to be anywhere near world championship. I don't even know why he's part of the company anymore.
Well, Big Papa, we have to have somebody to hate. Big Papa is one of the few truly with no positive side to him. He's a true maddening. Lambert is surprisingly weaker in this match.
Big Papa is carrying him.
So far, well, I mean, no. I thought we haven't seen an RWA night yet where every single match is changing. I know, but this one, if Big Papa wins this one, we might have a record in our hands. Because we have seen Mulito and Vex win the championship as well as Gunnar Allen. So, basically,
do you think when Renegades are holding the championship, they are going into the creeper pool?
It's possible. And that would probably make Omni and Vex like 3 or 4 time champions, but I don't think it does count. I don't.
They are in the ringside. I was expecting more hardcore action from this match. Well, it's a world championship match. There is very little hardcore championship in this match. Action in these champ matches usually, not counting the last one. Lambert Cooper defended the championship.
Big Popper's dizzy.
No. Why is Lambert...
Why is Big Popper such a big monster?
Well, he's a fat sex buffer, a disgusting horfit. He's actually unrepulsive. He's as repulsive as they are. Lambert, even Lambert probably feels uncomfortable touching him. And he's the guy who makes all those bizarre mutations.
Yes, who knows how will he punish Big Papa after he has been defeated.
Don't count your axiom. Big Papa has proven to be a challenge for things.
Guy was able to beat him last time, so maybe he's not as good as you may think.
Flavel Cruises. Who's Flavel?
It's... I think it's Cassie's boyfriend.
Oh yes, I think he was in that
Asinine anniversary match which had no commentary on. Yes, that was stupid.
Whoa, I know! This can't be true. Big Papa is the new world champion.
Every single title seems to be losing its word.
You cannot be serious, are you?
We have to find out what the hell is going to happen after this.
You got to be kidding me. No sex trafficker is going to beat Lambert Tomber. I thought you were going to be Big Papa is going to beat him.
What was that? Where is Big Papa?
What did the name of Big Papa just exploded?
Who did that? Was it Baron of Krieg? Who? What is up?
Hello, Lambert. It's me. Your brother. Who used to be known as Fistomber. I've laid foundation to my revenge. I was planning to blow up you, but then that fat man won the championship. So therefore, I am going to simply route that skin you take on me in a challenge. You are to erase everything in my life has gone wrong. Now it's payback time. This time, you will not be able to predict much I have changed. I am going to be reborn. You cannot stop me.
Oh my god. Was that Fistomber?
I think so, yes. He looked different.
Well, this is going to be interesting. Looks like Big Papa's reign and victory amounted to nothing after goddamn the title belt had a bomb set up in it, and we need to get a new big gold belt championship.
This is unfortunate as hell.
Well, I'm Rob Williams.
And I am Will Poppins.
Looks like this is going to be an interesting build-up to our next pay-per-view.